So my presentation actually is a little bit in between the presentations from Bas and Helene. Can you move to the next slide? So when Bas was presenting, he was showing the analysis that we usually do with global models, where we are looking into pathways that could bring us to 2 degrees or 1.5 degrees. And there's a lot of analysis done with global models. I think the SR 1.5 analyzed a couple of thousand scenarios. And we know quite a bit on these pathways, and among others, and that going to 2 degrees and 1.5 degrees means that we have to go to net zero. And Bas was already showing that there are different pathways to get there. But in the end, it's interesting to look at the global perspective because it relates directly to Paris, but implementation needs to happen at the regional level. If you go to the next slide. And then Helene was already indicating that if we do this analysis, that with global models, that we find that the NDCs, if you implement them and if we add them up for all countries, that they don't reach the level that is needed for 2 degrees or 1.5 degrees. And even worse, if we in the global models analyze all current policies, and then current policies at the moment globally don't reach the NDCs. And so there is an implementation gap. We're not implementing the NDCs yet. There's an ambitious gap. We don't, the NDCs are not ambitious enough yet to be leading to the Paris targets. Please, next slide. As we can do that analysis with global models, because they have regions, but they lack legitimacy in the country itself. It's much more interesting in the end to look at the Indian results with using Indian models, and they also lack detail. And so that's why in Engage, but also earlier in previous projects like Commit, we are working together with global modeling teams and national teams and to do joint analysis of similar goals and to find out what we can learn from that analysis. And I think the really nice thing is that it means that countries that are informed by national teams do get quite similar analysis results. And so the Indian government would be getting results from the Indian modeling team that has been working together globally. So at least the results are not influenced by methodological differences. Can you go to the next slide? Yeah, and we, in Engage, defined a systematic protocol to do that analysis. And it's quite difficult because it means that we're not only looking at different countries, we're also looking at different models in different countries. Next. Please. And so what we wanted to do is to, first of all, with all the modeling teams, ask them to run a current policy scenario. We also wanted them to look into the NDCs of their own country. And then we asked them, run systematically reduction targets in 2050. Please run a 50% emission reduction target. Please run a 100% emission reduction target if it's feasible in your country. And also run a net zero systematic run where we actually had specified the net zero years differently for different countries. Next slide, please. And we have modeling teams from all over the world. So we have teams from Brazil, we have two teams from China, two teams from India, three teams even from Japan, three teams from Korea. And so all these teams collaborated in implementing this protocol. Next slide, yes. So these are the results. Here you see the slides for different countries that were part of Engage. So Brazil, China, EU, India, Japan, Korea, Thailand, USA, and Vietnam. In some cases, you actually see multiple lines. That's caused because there were multiple teams participating. And then we see that if you would take a country where we have only one set, and let's take the case of Thailand. And then we see, first of all, the current policy scenario in red. We see the NDC as it's analyzed in yellow. And then we see the mitigation targets that we asked them to run, which were the 50% emission reduction, 100% emission reduction, and the stylized net zero year run. And that was done for all these different models. And so we get a very rich set of country-specific scenarios that we can use. Next slide, please. And we can then add them up again and do the same type of analysis that Helene was already presenting, but that was based on global analysis. We can now do it also based on the national models and analyze at the global scale what the results are. It actually more or less confirms the same picture, that we have the current policies still having a slight increase. The NDCs, we normally with the global models find somewhat a little decrease. Here it ends up in a slight increase. And then we have the mitigation scenarios. Please next. And yeah, the nice thing is that we can then analyze these national emission gaps. Yeah, so we can look at where do the NDCs end up, where do current policies end up, and typically we would find that the current policies would be somewhat above the NDCs and that there is still an implementation gap that needs to be filled in the different countries. Yeah, so here on the x-axis you see the different countries. We see the results for CO2 in the upper panel, the results for greenhouse gases in the lower panel, and then the different models. And again, for some countries, we have multiple model teams. We, in this slide, also compare it actually with the image model results. And so the results that Elaine was already showing in her analysis of the PBL's Institute of the Global System, we can compare it to what national teams find. And that actually allows us also to calibrate our model better. Next slide, please. And these are the results as well. So if you, here we have again all the 9 countries that we looked into, and what you see from going from left to right for each individual country are the results for current policy, the NDC, the 50% reduction, the 100% reduction, and this stylized net zero run. And what you can see, and just take a particular country like, for instance, Japan, if we look at first of all at the NDC run, we see that still there would be room for coal to use in Japan. But if you then move into the 50 and certainly the 100% emission reduction scenarios, this needs to be replaced by net zero options, like, for instance, the big increase in solar that we can see, but also in this case, according to the Japanese models that we were working with, an increase in biomass use. And we can see that the picture differs quite substantially across countries. Yeah? Brazil, for instance, has a very different solution than Japan, also in Korea. And so there is clearly a national differentiation here. Next slide. We can also see some commonalities. Here we have all countries again. And what we're plotting here is electricity use and fuel use in different sectors. The only thing that I would like to point out is in many countries, the red line, which is the electricity line, is increasing quite rapidly. And that's not so strange, and because it's relatively easy compared to other sectors to decarbonize the electricity sector. As a result, the models also like to use that advantage and electrify many end users. Next slide, please. This is another commonality that we find across all the countries, which is actually the more stringent the target is, the more renewables are used, and the renewables go up quite quickly as a result of the targets. So that makes sense as well, given the price decreases for renewables. Next slide. So some conclusions. National models can be used to explore pathways to net zero. The Engage modeling team has made this really attractive set of national scenarios that are consistent with global model runs, and that can be used to look into country-specific data with a high amount of legitimacy because they were used for national teams. The NDCs of several countries will still need to be aligned with the long-term targets. I was showing these 50% emission reductions runs. I was also showing the NDCs. You could easily see that they were not in line yet. Next slide. And yeah, there were also some general elements of net zero pathways that I found, even emphasizing as the last bullet, that there are also quite there are differences clearly visible between the countries. Thank you.